Welcome to my YouTube channel, which is titled Research Methods Class with Dr. Lydia Wabugo. In Research Methods, we have a book titled Research Methods, Theory and Practice. This book is accessible through the website where you can access the hard copy of the book or a downloadable PDF format of the book. In the same website, you are able to access all the courses, which includes the free research methods course, IBM SPSS statistics course, M&E consultancy course, which are available at a fee. Please find the links in the description. Welcome. Welcome to our lesson today, and this is our lesson 72, where we are going to explain the components of chapter 4 as it is titled. So chapter 4 is titled as Data Analysis, Presentation, Interpretation, and Discussion of Findings. But you may find some institutions carrying the discussion of findings to chapter 5, but for this lesson, we are going to discuss it under chapter 4. In our previous lesson, we have discussed the structure of chapter 4 and what to avoid when you are analyzing data or when you are presenting data in chapter 4. So this lesson, like we have said, it will explain those components of chapter 4 so that as you present, as you write your research project, thesis or dissertation, then you know what to include under each component. And that is our main outcome of this lesson. So like we have said, chapter 4 in many institutions is titled Data Analysis, Presentation, Interpretation, and Discussion of Findings. Now, note the arrangement. So some institution will omit the analysis and talk about presentation, interpretation, and discussion of findings because data analysis is not something you do in the document. You do it using the softwares like SPSS for quantitative data, and then you transport now the data into your document where you present, you interpret, and you discuss the findings. So by the end of this lesson, make sure that you understand what is done under each component. From lesson 46 to lesson 50, and also lesson 67 and 68, we have discussed data analysis in details. And we said, this is the process of reducing data to manageable summaries. And you can summarize or analyze data using statistics for quantitative data and thematic induction for qualitative research data. So for analysis, remember, based on the type of data you have, you will analyze data outside the research project or thesis or dissertation. Then now you bring it to the document where you start on data presentation. But if your institution allows or requires you to have the title as data analysis, presentation, etc., like we have said, then it must be shown in the title. So now we assume we have now analyze data and we are bringing it to our document, to our project, to our thesis or dissertation. So the first thing we need to do is to present the data. Data presentation refers to ways of arranging data to make it clear. And presentation is mainly by use of visuals or use of numbers. So we have various methods of presenting data. And for quantitative data, we have three main methods. And for qualitative, of course, we use verbatim or direct quotes. So we have graphical presentation where we use the graphs. Again, remember we said the graph that you use depends on the type of data that you collect or the scale of measurement. Bar graphs and pie charts are used for categorical data, whereas histograms, scatter diagrams, frequency polygons are used with data that is at continuous level. tabular presentation. This is the use of tables. And the common tables that we use in social science research are the frequency distribution tables and cross tabulation. These two tables are mainly used with categorical data. Of course, you may use tables when you are presenting your inferential statistics, and that is again for quantitative data. Then we have numerical presentation. This is the use of numbers, and this is where you present your data using either results from descriptive statistics or inferential statistics. And again, when you are presenting this data, you use tables, and the table will be dependent on the statistical tool that you are using. That is why we did not number it at the tabular. So remember, we also talked about the various descriptive statistics, the various inferential, parametric and non-parametric in our lessons from lesson 46. And then for qualitative, we presented verbatim or direct quotes, and we discussed that in lesson 68. So now, once we have presented data, we have used the visuals or numbers, we then interpret. So we have moved from data analysis, we have gone to data presentation, now we are at the point of data interpretation. Interpretation means searching for meaning and implication of the research results in order to make references, draw conclusions, and relate that to theory. So once the researcher presents the data, the next step is to search for meaning, and it is based on the research problem. Now, remember, when we were discussing characteristics of research problem, I think in lesson 5 or 6, we said that one of the characteristics of a good research problem is that it should be from an area of interest where you as a researcher, you have some basic knowledge. Now, this is where that point becomes very key, because when you're interpreting data, you interpret it searching for meaning of that data based on the research problem. So it is your finding vis-a-vis the research problem. There are some researchers, and especially students, who make an assumption that interpreting data means reporting in a statement format what is presented visually. So you find a student has presented a very nice frequency distribution table that shows the variable, the frequency, and the percentage. So when they come to data present the interpretation, then the researcher will indicate 60 into brackets 70.1% represents male, whereas 40 representing 29.9, these are all hypothetical, represent females, and they leave it at that point. That is not how you interpret data. You interpret data looking at that presentation of the variable gender in relation to your problem. So that now when you come to the discussion of findings, you are trying to find, to tie the findings to literature review. So the first one, you are tying it to your problem. Now the second one for discussion, you tie it to literature review. This is where you compare and contrast your own finding with other empirical findings reviewed in chapter 2. The purpose is to show whether your findings agree or disagree with the existing body of knowledge. Note that our findings does not always have to agree what is in the empirical literature. That is why discussion of findings comes in to tell the reader whether the findings agrees or contrast with the empirical literature. Now note, we do not have these subsections, but they flow in a continuous prose. But one would be able to tell this is the presentation, this is interpretation, and this is discussion. Now let us look at the example. Assume we had this title, which is a study that was comparing the performance of students in the Bachelor of Education Science course, those who are in distance and those who are on campus mode of learning. So the first thing is analysis, which you have said you do it elsewhere, and then you now import the table, if it was a categorical data and you are presenting a frequency distribution table into your document. So what we can see, table 4.1, is data presentation. So this is presented in a tabular format and it is frequency distribution table. So you can see we have the variable, which is gender, the frequency, and the percentage. Then we come to number two, data interpretation and the discussion of findings. And please note, like I have said, we do not show these subsections as we present and discuss our findings. It flows from when you presented in the visual in your explanation. So when the researcher is interpreting this data, they interpret it based on the problem. So if I go back to my table, it shows the gender of the students in both distance and on-campus students. So the researcher will interpret this variable called gender in relation to the problem of the study, which was to compare the academic performance. So when you look at this table, we have more females in the distance mode of learning than females, and that is what the researcher will present. So we have more females than males, and then the researcher links that finding to the problem. So, and that is why she says that this could be a pointer that there exist gender gaps in science performance at the Kenya Certificate of Secondary Education. Then when you come to the discussion of findings, now you link that finding to the literature so that you can either find for coherence or whether your study contrasts with what is in the empirical data. And you can see the discussion of finding for that is that the researcher wrote, the ODE mode of learning attracted more females than males, and it concurs with a study that had been done in 2002 that found that females enrolled in distance education classes, they enrolled more at a higher rate than males because of the flexibility of the mode of learning. So all that is the quantitative data. So if the study was incorporating both quanti and quali, once you have completed with the quantitative data, you now bring in the qualitative. Note that we have only shown the qualitative. We have only shown the descriptive statistics. If the researcher was testing hypotheses, that should all come before you bring in the qualitative data. So once the researcher discusses the finding, then you bring in the qualitative data that is in coherence with the finding as it is shown. So that brings us to the end of our lesson, where we have discussed the components of chapter 4, and these are data analysis, data presentation, data interpretation, and discussion of findings. So in our next lesson, we are going to discuss chapter 5 of the research project, thesis or dissertation. Please like this lesson, share it with your friends, and do not forget to subscribe to the Research Methods Class YouTube channel, and feel free to ask any question on the comment section.